Would you like to know what happens in QuickBooks Online when you easily record a sales tax payment? Well, then stay tuned to this video where we will learn how to record paying sales tax. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Paying sales tax in QuickBooks Online also only takes several seconds. You must record the payment from the sales tax center if you want the sales tax center to reflect the fact that that particular tax period has been paid. You must pay for a specific sales tax period at the moment that you're paying sales tax, and the payment will be recorded like any other transaction that you would record in QuickBooks Online. The payment will affect the reports in QuickBooks Online the same way that any other payment in any other situation would affect the QuickBooks Online reports. QuickBooks Online assumes that you are filing a return with the sales tax payment. QuickBooks Online assumes that the payment was physically sent at the moment you record the payment. For example, let's imagine on November 17th, we paid the overdue amount of $12.50 from the sales tax period July 1 to September 30. Now, if we do that, what will be the result? Well, in the sales tax center, the overdue amount of $12.50 that you see here will disappear and show up instead at the very top in the section of paid taxes. Don't forget to set the date range wide enough so that you can see how it moves from one section to the other. And what will be the result in the trial balance after recording the sales tax payment? Well, the sales tax that we owe will decrease because we paid some, and the amount that's indicated owed after that will decrease to $62.50. Also, because we're paying, cash in bank decreases by the amount we're paying. And because we're paying $12.50 and cash in the bank has a zero balance, cash in the bank will show up in the trial balance for the first time as a negative $12.50. Let's take a look at how to record this. The way to record paying sales tax is to open the sales tax center and make the date range wide enough to see the sales tax period that you're paying for. So if you only keep it the current month, you won't see anything overdue. But because we know if we make the date going back to September and click refresh, we know that the prior period's tax return and tax payment was due back on October 20. So the way that we pay this is first to click View Return. Now, of course, this is just a summary of everything that would normally go on the tax form that you would have to send to your state tax department when you send in your tax payments. All it does is show you the relevant summary information, and all you have to do to record a payment is to click Record Payment. Now, you have to tell QuickBooks the payment date, and we said in our example it would be November 17th. And you have to tell QuickBooks which bank account the payment is being paid from. And because we only have one bank type of account on the list, we click here and click Record Payment. Now, we can close out this window, or we can just click back to Sales Tax Center. Now notice, the payment of $1,250 or the amount of $1,250 has now moved from the overdue section of the sales tax center to the paid section of the sales tax center for the $1,250, and the only thing upcoming is the $62.50 here that you see is a different sales tax period, not payable yet. And the grand finale is to check the trial balance. We click reports and double click trial balance, and you can see that the Massachusetts Tax Department, the account in the trial balance that represents what we owe, has decreased to $62.50. If we double click, you can scroll across and you can see that we originally owed $75 before this payment. And this payment is recorded on the last line, see? We had these sales that accumulated the sales tax. And then this last sales tax payment, the last transaction on the bottom, decreases by the amount we paid, and the remaining amount we owed is $62.50.